Hi, my name is Sonny Halberg, and today I'm going to talk about the effects of lubrication and friction in a bolted joint. Friction is the bad guy. We don't like friction. As I will show you here, approximately 85 to 90% of your torque will actually go to overcome friction, and only 10 to 15% will actually generate a preload in your joint. If this is a bolted joint, then you have your clamps part in between the bolt and the nut. And if I do tighten the nut, it will generate a torsion of the bolt. A bolt is not designed to take torsion. A bolt is designed to take preload, which stretches the bolt. Now, it's not because I'm strong. It is just a spring, this one. And I can also show you that if you had a very short clamp length and you did the tightening up here, there will be no torsion of the bolt, which means that the friction underneath the head is not dangerous. It's the friction in the thread that is dangerous. When we are talking about bolted joint, we usually talk about one torque, one friction coefficient, and then we get one preload. But in real life, that is not actually the case. You will always have a deviation in your friction, and you also actually have a deviation in your tightening tool, which generates that you, instead of having just one preload, you will actually get a maximum preload and a minimum preload. And what you need to consider is to get this gap between the maximum and the minimum to be as small as possible for you to utilize the bolt the most. What can we do to minimize it? Well, we can actually lubricate. And the graph I'm going to show you now is three different bolts, same size, same grade, taken from the same box, but it is three different bolts, tightened to approximately the same torque, which you can see out here. And the orange graph that you have here is with adhesive, and with that torque, you will get around 26 kilonewtons. The red graph is a bolt taken directly from the box, nothing done to it. And then you will get a preload of 41 kilonewtons. And if you use a good lubricant, you will get to 63 kilonewtons. And the only difference between these three graphs is actually the friction. Now, in this, I have tightened three bolted joints from the same box to the same torque and no lubrication. As you can see here, you will get a deviation of 9 kilonewtons in the preload. But what will happen if we take three other bolts from the same box, but this time we use a good lubricant? The deviation is now only 4 kilonewtons, which is what we want, get more control. This is first time use. I will actually now talk about what happens during reuse. And the first we're gonna look at is reuse without lubrication. First time you use it, you will get to about 34 kilonewtons. But the next time you use it, you only get to 20, and then it will go down. And the risk is that this big drop is not inside the calculation of what the design engineers was thinking about. So if the design engineers think you're gonna get this higher clamp load and you only get this higher clamp load, you will actually have a small chance of the bolted joint will open, and with time it will suffer fatigue failure. Now, let's do the same test with lubrication. New bolt taken from the same box, but this time we have used a good lubricant, and now we tighten it 10 times again. And as you can see here, the deviation is only a couple of kilonewtons. So you are good to go. Even when you retighten it, you are still in the window of the design engineer's calculations. That was all for me. And thank you for listening, and I hope you learned something about bolted joints. And if you have any questions, do please contact us.